Hello, guys, and welcome to another episode of FJU TV. Jocelyn, what do we have in store for these people today?
Well, first, we got to talk about where we are. Look, it's behind us.
Right, the Hollywood sign. Guys.
Today, we're going to be talking about a really important subject about power. Many youths, our physical power. Not only our physical power, but our spiritual power as well. But also, we will have What's Up with Ernie. We'll have the Q&As.
Yep.
And we'll have a special guest. You want to know who our special guest is?
You're going to have to wait a little bit.
All right, so stay tuned. And my name is Jocelyn.
My name is Joseph.
And you're watching FJU TV. Welcome back to FJU TV. Before we get started, we need to mention about our social networks, right, Joseph?
Yes, you guys can find us on Instagram at FJU Cali. You guys can also find us on Facebook at FJU Cali. And don't forget to add us on Snapchat at FJU_TV.
Also, if you have any questions, if you have any comments, and regarding the topics that we will be discussing in FJU TV, you can always send them at the email at tv@fjuniversal.com. So now, before we get started, it's time for
What's Up With Nerdy? Hello guys, and welcome to What's Up With Ernie here from the Hollywood sign. There's a beautiful view right here, and you know, today's topic is about strength, like you guys already know, and I'm going to be giving you guys some amazing facts about that and how animals are really strong. So here goes the first fact. Did you guys know that gorillas are like so strong that they can carry 10 times their body weight? Like, that's amazing, you know, like they're already fat and like strong, I guess, and then adding 10 times that, like, it's like, dude, it's a lot. And also, I mean, they're strong, but they're not as strong as the African elephant, which is the strongest mammal, and can carry up to, well, can carry the weight like 130 adults. Like, dude, that's a lot of weight. You know, I have friends that are pretty heavy, you know, and some of them here in the crew, actually, you know, so that's a lot of people, you know. So yeah, guys, those are my facts for today. And just another thing, you know, I know that Joseph and Justin are going to be adding to this. Strength is not just about how much things you can carry, because human strength is all going to go, you know, it's all going to end sometime. You're not going to be able to carry everything. And also animals, they can only be so strong. So they're going to be talking about that thing you need in order to be strong, to be able to do anything, guys. So I'll see you guys here next time on What's Up With Ernie, and I hope you guys enjoy the rest of the show with Justin and Joseph, okay?
Mi nombre es Rubicela Alemán, tengo 34 años y esta es mi experiencia con el Espíritu Santo. Bueno, antes de recibir el Espíritu Santo, tenía ganas de suicidarme a causa de problemas que tenía en mi familia. Perdí mi carro, mi apartamento, mi familia, tenía muchos pleitos con mi esposo. También tenía mucho rencor, mucho odio. Y por a causa de todo eso, también sufría mucho de pesadillas, insomnio en las noches. Cuando perdí a mis hijos, es cuando yo dije, no, yo necesito cambiar. Y empecé a frecuentar a la iglesia y a hacer mis cadenas. Empecé a buscar para mí misma, para que yo pudiera estar fuerte y bien para poder ayudar a mi familia. Bueno, para recibir el Espíritu Santo, tuve que reflexionar en mí misma, que yo tenía que cambiar, que tenía que perdonar, dejar el pecado. Empecé a ayunar, empecé, you know, a luchar más en los días miércoles, los domingos cuando buscábamos. Incluso yo también buscaba en mi casa, yo sola, leer mi Biblia, ayunar, buscar pues con todas mis fuerzas la presencia del Espíritu Santo. Bueno, yo los invito a hacer el ayuno de Daniel para que usted se venga a fortalecer. Hay una salida. Dios, Él existe, Él vive dentro de uno. Le da la fuerza para salir adelante, lograr lo que uno quiere, vencer sus problemas y tener esa grande paz dentro de uno. Tener fuerzas para luchar. Y los invito a todos que vengan y hagan lo mismo que yo hice. Que aprovechen este ayuno de Daniel que estamos teniendo estos 21 días.
Hey guys, and welcome back to FJU TV. So we're here today with our special guests. It's Frank.
Hey. So he's here with us today.
What's up?
Pleasure to have you here.
Yep.
It's pretty warm.
It's very hot today.
Hot today.
The California weather.
California weather, guys. Anyways, Frank, you know, so can you tell us a little bit of, you know, how you got to the FJU? What struggles did you go through, and you know how you were able to overcome them?
So before coming to the youth group at here, I remember that I had these problems, which were drugs. I was addicted to drugs. I had an addiction of video games. I used to have this anger, this like I would not sleep at night. I would see things, and I would have, you know, that hatred against my father. And I wouldn't have a strong communication with my mom too, so.
Okay, and so, I mean, obviously, you know, coming to the youth group, you were able to overcome all that, you know? So, what is it that gave you the strength for you to overcome, and at any point in, you know, the time, did you lose that strength?
I did loses strength, I began to like lose my way. I started to focus on other things which weren't, you know, good at the time. I began to fall back and have my old habits I used to have, and that caused me to fall and caused me to do all these things that I would not imagine myself doing. And that it was a rough time because I would think that, you know, like no one was there for me, that all these problems, you know, I would not sleep at night because I knew that, like, I knew these problems were there, but I wouldn't have the strength to, like, overcome them. So, yeah. So
we know that you lost that strength and you were trying to look for it. So what were the obstacles that you had to go through in order to reach like, those strengths?
Those days, I mean, like, I remember, like, trying to come back was really hard, the roughest thing ever. But I mean, like, I had to make a choice. I had to make a decision to get up and fight and not just like be there and just wait until those things come to me. You know, I had to make an action and I had to make sure that I could, you know, fight and have the strength back to overcome these problems that I had once again.
And so now, you know, that, you know, you're back, you know, you got that strength back again. So now, do you still have the same problems? Are you still, addicted once again?
Or I mean, like, of course, temptation comes every day, but I mean, like, I won't, the desires are not there, you know. I have, like,
you have strength, though.
Yes, yes, basically that as well, you know, it's very, like, nasty. I don't know, to when I, like, smell the drugs or not, like, see it or not, that when I just like, I don't know, that when I'm around like people who do that, you know, that when I am at work or something, that I'm just like, oh, you know, like back away from me. I don't want that stuff.
You know, and you know, to the youth out there, you know, who are watching your testimony, you know, and maybe they say, you know, what is this strength? Like, what is he talking about? You know, what would you tell them? What advice would you give them? You know, maybe like you felt, you know, they felt weak, they felt alone. What would you tell them? You know, what advice would you give them?
I would say you have a decision to make, a decision to stay, you know, like down, to just be the same person, or you have, okay, so basically you have two decisions. One, to stay down on the floor, or to get up and do something about these problems. And these are the two options you have. And you have to make a difference and say, you know what, I'm not planning to be this person. I don't want to be, you know what, I don't want to have this, these like problems. And yeah, you know,
All right, guys, so that's Frank's story. You know, stay tuned. We're going to come back with questions and answers.
Right? Yes, indeed. Stay tuned and we'll be right back. Thank you.
All right, guys, we're here in the questions and answers segment of the show. So, Ernie, what's the first question for us today?
Our first question is for you, Joseph. What is the difference between physical and spiritual strength?
Well, I mean, there's definitely, you know, a big difference between spiritual and physical strength. Because, you know, I'm sure all of you guys have seen, you know, huge, you know, buff people walking around. You know, like you said earlier, you know, they look like gorillas, you know, they're so big. But, you know, they have addictions to drugs, alcohol, you know, it could be anything, you know, even pornography, you know. Their lives are dominated by these little things, you know. They might be strong physically, they might, you know, bench press me, you know, but at the end of the day, they're not strong enough. They don't have the spiritual strength to let go of what's affecting and, you know, ruining their lives. So, you know, that's what I think.
Yes, and to you, Jocelyn, the question is, what is real strength?
Our real strength is, of course, the spiritual strength. As you said, the physical strength is only on the outside. You can go to the gym like twice a day, but I mean, that's only filling us with outside. You know, it's not on the inside. We can be so empty that we need to find that spiritual strength. And how do we find that spiritual strength? Well, there's many ways we can do it. There's prayers, fastings, reading the Bible. It's those things that actually maintain ourselves from being stable and from us having those pieces. And that way, when we go to problems, when we go to situations in our life, we're able to confront them.
Yes, definitely. And the strength that all these fast prayers and reading the Bible, what that all leads to is, you know, building a communion with God. And that leads to receiving the Holy Spirit, right, Joseph? And right now, we're actually living a real good fast that you guys can all join. Can you explain that, Joseph?
Yeah, look, the fast, you know, as we said it, the last episode is a fast of Daniel. We're staying away from social media. We're staying away from, you know, IG, Snapchat, Facebook,
Netflix.
You know, all that stuff. You know, I'm missing my shows right now, you know. But, you know, it's all worth it because, you know, this is like the gym for us, you know. People go
to,
you know, this is our workout, you know, where we're putting our faith into work, you know, for us to receive this strength, for us to be able to, you know, let go of what's harming us and build, you know, that strength with God. Right, Jocelyn?
Right, exactly. And during these 21 days, it's to let go of these distractions. Like I said last week, that a lot of us have a lot of distractions. Like, I don't know if you noticed, but so much time is taking out from me watching those shows and, like, checking on Facebook, checking on that I realize, like, oh my gosh, my priorities are, like, on the other side, like, towards the other side, and I'm only focusing on what's right in front of me.
Yeah.
So this fast of Daniel is an opportunity for you if you haven't been having your communion with God. Maybe you're, like, Frank's testimony, how he was apart from God, from the presence of God. It's an opportunity. It's an opportunity for each and every one of you. So, yeah.
All right, guys, so that's all for today, you know, and join us next week. We're going to be somewhere in California, you know, exploring. So make sure you guys join us. And like we said, you know, try to come and join this fast. You know, it's not too late yet. There's still time. So come and look for this spiritual strength because I'm sure you guys will benefit a lot. Okay, my name's Joseph.
My name is Jocelyn.
What's up with Ernie guy here?
All right, and this has been FJU TV.
Bye.
All right, I need to clap in 3, 2, 1.
Hello, guys.
Yeah, hello.
What's up, guys? Welcome to What's Up with Ernie. Oh, you was it recording?
Go ahead.
So, Brian's going to tell us a little bit about his story today. So, as you guys know, today's segment is about strength, you know. So, Frank, at a certain point in time, you know, did you have this strength, you know, because I know that...
Yeah. I began, you know, with hanging out with the wrong people, so that's when, you know, all the bad habits started to happen. And the way I began to overcome it, do I have to talk about it straight?
Thanks for having us once again.
Thanks,
right? Thank you. We're seeing
you guys in a bit. And Jocelyn, the question we have for you is, what is spiritual strength?
Real strength. The spiritual strength.
Oh my God.